little bit taller, but he looks amazingly technically well.
I know, yesterday, the other day, when we saw him in the semifinal, we looked at each other and said, oh my gosh, he looks exactly like Alan Johnson.
Track. Now let's do it off the track, man. I salute you, and man, I'm proud of you.
Terrence, man, we want to wish you congratulations. Let you know how much you've inspired us. You inspired our daughter. In fact, we just came from a cross-country track meet this morning, and we had to go to this track meet 50 miles away because of you. Jordan did a great job. So we salute you, man. We wish you the very, very best. You guys, it's an honor to know you and Tracy as well. So thank you guys so much. You've been a blessing to us. We wish you the absolute, absolute best in the future. God bless you.
God bless you.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that this ain't too hard to believe. Cause baby, you're the only one for me. I know it get hard when I'm moving in and out of state, but I promise my heart for you I would save. Just remember that.
This man deserves every single bit of everything that's on this table he's worked hard to get. Everybody here is here to celebrate this man. We're gonna have a good time tonight, but we gotta start it off right.
Just to come and celebrate your 14 years on USA World Track Circuit.
Circuit.
I get it. Right. I've gotten to know many, many people, your frat brothers, a whole bunch of people via email, text. I've been blowing people up. I've had my phone secret for the past couple weeks, and I'm going anywhere now. You so know you might see someone. We're all here to honor and celebrate you on the wonderful things you've done. So at this time, if you all would like to get some food and then just mix and mingle so he can actually see actually who everyone is. I don't think he's even broken back. Every time I turn my head, I see someone else. So thank you all for coming. So we'll get some food, mix and mingle, and then we'll have some presentations and break from there. Okay, and then dance. So I hope everybody, I know you have kids. Kids are at home, so this is your time to party.
Who wants the perfect love story anyway? Anyway, cliche, 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 cliche. Who wants that hero love that saves the day? Anyway, cliche, 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 cliche. What about the bad that goes good? Yeah, an innocent love, I misunderstood. Yeah, black our glass, toast to cliches in the dark past. Toast to cliches in the dark past. Thank you.
got the best in you.
Mix and mingle with everyone. At this time, we're going to have a couple short presentations from Terrence's friends, his family, trackmates, a little bit of everyone. So first, the first person we're going to have come up is Jared. Excuse my car. Is Jared Wallace? Jared is a two-time world record holder. He holds the record in the 200 meter at the World Championship and also the 4x100 meter relay in the Paralympics. So he's going to speak at the moment.
Thank you. Like she said, my name is Jared Wallace, and I run the U.S. Paralympic track team. Just an honor to be here tonight to celebrate your amazing career, Terrence, and to just go meet friends and family. Terrence, you're the best coach I've worked with, man. Not because you taught me how to start out of the blocks, not because you taught me running mechanics, not because you taught me how to run the 100 meters, or what to think about in the short time that it takes, but because you taught me how to believe. You taught me how to believe in my talent, you taught me how to believe in my training, you taught me how to believe my instinct, most importantly, you taught me to believe in myself. And I believe you did that because you first believed in me, and no one else did. Appreciate it, man. I hope you have a chance to work together again. And I remember the thing you always told me at the end of your practice. Perfect first, perfect faster.
If you all want to get to know more about Jared, visit his website. You'll be totally astounded by just seeing him and then actually reading his story. What just transpired within the last few years. You can go to alleginfaith.com and read all about his beautiful, wonderful story. So thank you, Jared, for speaking. Next, we will have his coach, Coach Paige. He's gonna come and say some words.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm just going to shoot from the hip here, all right? And I want to say, well, first of all, you know, it's good to be involved with someone so humble. It's good to experience meeting all the people that are involved, you know, in someone's everyday life. I mean, looking around, everyone has come to help celebrate. I want to say that I'm going to make this short. But anyway, when this thing first started in somewhere 2007, you know, Terrence came to me and asked if I would coach him. And we sat and we talked, and I said, I'll get back with you. So I went home and I said, I saw him run before. And I said, well, let me go home and study just a little bit because, you know, this is a big time name coming to me. And I said, so I went and I studied for a couple of days and I got back to him. But before I got back to him, I said, how in the world am I going to make a guy who has two Olympic silver medals better? I said, that's one heck of a chore. So I said, you know what? I'm going to give it a shot. So he came to me. He trusted me. You know, we had a very, very nice career together. He excelled. He did well. He worked hard. You know, and like I said earlier, it's nice to be able to have someone who has a terrific following, you know, applause for all of you all. And then to meet other folks that are involved, such as Josh and his wife, you know, his chiropractors, masseuse, and Jared, and, you know, you got Dwight and Angelo. So it's just been a pleasure, and it's made me a better coach. Hopefully, I have made him a better athlete and person, and that's about all I have to say. But it's been just a wonderful opportunity that he has presented to me, and I feel much better as a person, and that's what he has done for me. And I hope I've done the same for him.
Thank you.
That we're gonna have come up is a fellow Olympian, has many gold medals and all, and he's on the cover of what's cereal box? What was it?
Kellogg's.
You'll see him triple jumping on the cover of the cereal. Long jumping, sorry, on the cover of the cereal box. So
long jumping. Well, I have so much to say, really. I wore this blue in honor of the second best school in the Cab County's office, the Cab. But on a more serious note, I've known Terrence since high school. We really didn't speak much in high school because, you know, he was that guy that's always winning. And of course, when you're winning all the time, nobody really wanted to talk to you like that. But, we made our first Olympic team together in 2000, and this story, like, really, it changed my life. During my long jump final, Terrence had already won his silver medal, Angelo had won his gold medal, and I'm in the finals of long jump, the biggest stage in the world, and I'm just thinking, I cannot let the cater down. You know, I gave it everything I had, and I ran down that track as fast as I could, and I landed, I landed face first on the dirt, had dirt all over my hair, just everywhere. And I finished eighth place. And I was devastated because I was like, I really disappointed Decatur. But, you know, 4 years later, I was able to come back and win the gold medal in the Olympics. And I have to really attribute a lot of that because of the inspiration that I had drawn from you and Angelo. I just really wanted to kind of like uphold a tradition of us coming from this small area and making it like the grandest thing ever. Like, we're very proud of Decatur. And I was just proud to, you know, have you as a friend, you know, as a teammate. And I know it's a friendship that will last forever, man. And thank you for everything.
Thank you.
Is someone I got to know very well within the last few months. We sent many messages back and forth via Facebook, and he almost spoiled it on Facebook a million times. But this person is very dear to Terrence. So this is his line brother, which I call LB Destin. He's going to come up and say a few words. Hey.
Man. I don't even know where to start. We go back. I don't even know if T remembers this. I transferred to USC in 2000, and on the track team, you know the Olympians that are gonna be on the track training with you and stuff like that. See, I was Terrence Trammell in practice. So one day I'm walking back, this was like the first week of school, and I'm walking back to the dorm, and I see this big black truck, like 25 inch rims, pull up next to me. I'm like, well, he rolls the window down. Need a ride? I said, yeah. So I get in the truck, right? And we just talking like, you know, like I was an Olympian. I'm sitting here like, am I really having a conversation with Terrence Trammell? You know, the silver medal, everybody won the silver medal in the Olympics. So that just lets you know what kind of man this is. Before he even knew me, I was just a transfer. You know, I wasn't anybody. Here is a silver medalist picking me up just to give me a ride to the dorm. Fast forward. 6 months later, well, we had it out in his apartment. Because he lived off campus. Nah, this man right here, you know, there's nothing. All that stuff on that table, that shows what he did on the track. Everybody here knows, I mean, his name speaks for itself. Those medals, those awards, that's just a testament to his hard work. his determination, his sacrifice, his commitment, you know, but that doesn't describe the man I know standing next to me. This man I know right here isn't a bunch of medals, he isn't a bunch of, you know, championship world titles and things like that. He's a man, he's a good husband, he's a good father, he's a good friend. You know, a lot of times people, they wait till people are gone to give them their flowers. So I'm glad we're giving this man his flowers while he's yet living, because he deserves every bit of this. He's accomplished so much in his life, and it's just the beginning. You know, it's that was one chapter. Whatever he does is going to be successful. You know, the next chapter. And I'll always be there with him. He's been a role model, not just my OB. He's been a role model to me since day one. I've looked up to this guy, you know, and I can't say enough. You know, it's funny, I'm a big talker, like Tracy said. I almost spoiled it on Facebook a couple times. You know, everybody knows me, knows I have a big mouth, but one of the only times in my life right now I'm kind of speechless, because, you know, this is just something that, you know, coming down here from New Jersey, it's just, you know, it's not telling him. I talked to him last night, and I couldn't even tell him I was coming. It killed me, but now I'm just rambling, so. But nah, I love this guy to death. You know, it's my OB, my best friend, you know. I came down for the wedding in the living room. I was the photographer. But nah, yeah, you know, there's nothing much more I can say that you guys already know, that he doesn't show in every day of his life and every way he walks and every way he talks. So he deserves all this. Love you, LB. Yeah.
One more person that's going to speak, and then we have a few small presentations after that. So this next gentleman, get your tissue ready, because I have a sad feeling. Is his brother, Terrence Trammell. Not in that way, but the way Travis, you'll see. Nothing against them, it's just the way Travis speaks, you know, so. Travis,
come on up. See, that's why I wanted to go before him.
This guy is my brother, my fraternity brother, my prayer partner, my inspiration. He is the best man I know. He's my daughter's godfather, and when my wife and I found out that we were having a daughter, you know, we were kicking names back and forth, you know.
We're gonna name the baby.
I said, well, I know two of the names, Trammell and Rashawn. My brother's middle name is Rashawn, so you hear the family always call me Sean. That's how he knows at every race or every sporting event exactly where the family is, because we call him Sean. And everybody who knows him by Terrence is all, who's Sean? But yeah, I love him so much, I named my first child after him. Like, man, you are the bum. We had a great father. But you're the first man I ever loved. Wow. There's nothing that I would not do. I love you. Thank you. And I think I was asked to make an announcement too, as far as, you know, the guys who are kind of hanging loose tonight will actually go over to 255 Peter Street to watch the fight, and you know, so we can have a little guy time. So now that I start crying a little bit, I'm gonna leave y'all with something. Because it wouldn't be right if I didn't leave you with a little something. So I remember growing up, you know, we had like one of these hard working moms. Is she? Beautiful mom. You know, my brother and I are like 9, almost 10 years apart. And so we used to, you know, just jive each other all the time. Like, who's the oops?
I'm pointing no elbow.
And so he wanted to look at Melvin about my mama's house. And I just remember growing up, you know, mom would always do everything she could to feed us. You know, she worked, you know, a job and a half. She'd be sewing on the side, doing things for the church, you know, decorating the church, altering somebody's clothes. It was always something. And, you know, she always did so much for us. And so I would be remiss if I paid homage to my brother without paying homage to my mom.
Yeah.
Oh, you, Grace.
Next, we're going to have a couple. We were supposed to have a video presentation, but unfortunately there were a few technical errors and difficulties when setting it up here. So we'll share that separately and privately when we get a chance. But we do have a few other presentations, and after that, you know, we'll dance and mix and mingle for the evening. So Arius is going to come up next. He's the Zeta Zeta chapter of Terrence's. And he has a small, two small presentations. And then we'll have one more, and then that'll be it. So
I journeyed here today for many reasons. I'm here to tell you that I love you, and I'm happy about your life, happy about your progress. But I'm also here on the university capacity to present to you some words and representations of love from the University of South Carolina and the athletic department. First, I have a video from the Coach Fry, so you can see it.
It's a sad day and a great day. Terrence, I want to say congratulations on an incredible career. And thank you for taking me along for the ride and many of us. I like to think of faith in, as you know me, you categorize bucket list of quality experiences. In my career, one of the most quality, probably the most memorable experiences, the SEC Championship. Florida, Coach Miller, John Capel, Bernard Mintz, Terrence Trammell. 5 minutes before that race, you just ran the second fastest time ever run in history in 55 meter hurdles. Everybody was mumbling, you know, that why I let you run, you know, you can't even give me a big hug. So you talk about his Terrence, and I'll never pull this off. And you start crying, you give me a big hug, and say, Coach, I'll get it for you. I'll never forget it. Appreciate it. You stepped up to me. Three Olympians, it's 55 meters. From that point on, you're going to be the NCAA double champion. And son, you chose this school. Because God led you to it. He told me that you were out for your birthday. A man walked up to you and was sick from hell. And the man told you that you should go to college. You were drinking milk. Your brother took you out for birthday. Where he is coaching, man. And he said, Carolina. And he said, Coach Fry. You said, well, I'm going to Carolina. He said, well, Chapel Hill. He said, no, South Carolina. You said that signal told you that God spoke to you should go to college. I'm so glad God spoke to you. That day forward, Terrence, you delivered God a great stage. You step on his stage and you deliver a great message for man. A man of integrity, a man of honesty, a man of faith. Appreciate you, son. If you ever need me, I'm here. But I sure have no home for a ride. Congratulations. Go forward to next step, continue on that stage of God.
my finishing.
You need me to hold something?
Yep, I'm finished.
Boy, there's so many things.
I'm still holding on.
I'm
still holding on.
Don't change.
No, they don't
change.
They really don't. All right, first, Coach Fry was very excited about this event. We couldn't make it. So they went through every last container at the track, looking for stuff to send to the champs. So, you can still see his
name,
property of Coach Fry. These are pictures from, you know what these are?
Yeah.
1999, it's a good year.
Yeah.
Nice year.
Championship in 2000.
All right.
This is when we won right here. This is in 1999 in Boise, Idaho. This is when we won the first ever national championship for the University of South Carolina. In our relay, we beat LSU, TCU, Southern Cal, all of the quote unquote. This picture is from my junior year at Arkansas. This is the indoor national championships where I became the first person in history to win the NCAAs in the sprint as well as the hurdles.
Wow.
Once again, I said I'm here on official university duties. This is a letter from Coach Ray Tanner, signed. Dear Terrence, congratulations on your retirement from professional track and field competition. You have had an illustrious career at an elite level, but we are very proud that you began that career here at the University of South Carolina. You elevated our track and field program when you were here with your stellar performances at the NCAA Indoor and Outdoor Championships, winning gold many times. While I was a baseball coach here at USC, best in the world. Signed, Coach Fry, Coach D. Quillis, Coach Mike, Coach James, and Coach Brown.
That we have before we get a few acknowledgments from the man of the hour. The next one, we have a commendation from Lee May, who is the interim chief executive officer of DeKalb County, Decatur. It says, whereas, he's always repping Decatur, you know, the dick. It says, whereas DeKalb County honors Terrence Trammell for his international success in track and field at the Games of the 27th Olympiad in Sydney, Australia, and the Games of the 28th Olympiad in Athens, Greece. And whereas Terrence earned a silver medal in the 110-meter hurdles at both the 2000 and 2004 Summer Olympic Games, he also earned silver medals at the 2003 and 2007 World Championships and two gold medals at the Indoor World Championships. Whereas Terrence is a DeKalb County resident, born in Decatur, Georgia, and attended DeKalb County schools beginning at Bob Mathis Elementary School. And finally, Southwest DeKalb High School, where he earned the 1997 title of Track and Field News Male High School Athlete of the Year. Whereas, while attending the University of South Carolina, Terrence continued his track and field career and earned medals during the events, including the NCAA Indoor and Outdoor Championships, whereas Terrence qualified for the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing, but due to a hamstring injury during the preliminary rounds, he was unable to continue in the competition. Despite this injury, Terrence continued to train over the years with his high school coach, Napoleon Cobb. Whereas Terrence is retiring, possibly, from the sport, his unwavering commitment to his training and determination played an integral role in his 14-year career on the world circuit. Now, therefore, I, Lee May, on behalf of DeKalb County and his more than 700,000 citizens, do hereby commend Terrence Trammell for his legacy of athletic excellence in track and field, proclaimed this 14th day of September
2013. I don't know if you're taking a picture of him.
No, I'm gonna screenshot it.
Okay, so at this time we'll have a brief. We're gonna have a few acknowledgments by Terrence. Then we're gonna turn the party up. Everybody's gonna dance and have a good time. So we'll just. Oh, before we finish out, Angelo Taylor. I was told that he wanted to say something before we close. I was like, come on up, Angelo. Two-time gold medalist, 400-meter hurdle.
Good evening, everybody. My brother right here. We've been on many teams together. Went to high school together. Won state championships together. Been on three Olympic teams together. This is my brother right here. My brother from another mother. Man, I love you. It's been an amazing ride. You've been an inspiration. We had our ups and our downs. And, you know, I love you, man. You know, you're there for me. You're doing my hard times. You know, and I appreciate everything you've done for me. You know, we had many talks. You've been inspiring. You inspired me. I inspire you. And it's just been an amazing ride, man. You deserve everything here today. Everyone that's came out, you know, so much love in the room. And, you know, I'm at a loss for words, man. Just amazing to have someone along with you, this long career that you can just relate to and talk to. Because I never thought in a million years that I would be an Olympian. And it was something I wasn't prepared for. And any time that, you know, I was having, you know, moments, I can always lean on this guy right here. I just want to say I love you, brother.
All that's true. I just thank God for this moment. Thank you for my wife. We put all this together and put one over on my boy. And she looks so lovely this evening. Guys, this is one of the happiest moments of my life. Just to have everybody I know from all different circles in one place just to celebrate me. My brother gets on me a lot for not really using my accomplishments and my celebrity to do certain things with. But you know, I always felt that a man and a winner, a true champion, always lets his accomplishments speak for him. You know, your reputation always precedes you. They know that when you're in the area, you affect change. The one thing that I am really happy about, outside of all of the stats and things like that, one stat that I will add is that in Track and Field News, I think it was in 2011, they talked about some of the best track athletes of this particular era. And I was the only sprinter slash hurdler in the entire world ranked in the top 10 in the world for a decade straight. Wow. I'm really proud of that. I really appreciate that, because that it goes to show hard work and consistency really pays off and sheer determination. I'd like to thank my mom for going through with it. That great day in 1978. I wanna thank my dad, may he rest in peace, for always giving me words of encouragement and always being positive. And even though he wasn't in the house, he was always accessible.
That's right.
And I appreciate him for that. And just here the last month or so, for those that really know me, know how much I love football. And I took it upon myself to coach a little league team down in my area. And as only God had it, I found myself coaching the offensive line, which is exactly what my dad used to coach. And the ironic thing about it is, he and I never talked about the offensive line. So I spent many long nights out there every week. Every week. But during those moments, I always feel like my dad is right there with me. And that's why I enjoy it, and that's why I love it. I want to thank my mom for showing what love is, for at times being a mom and a dad, working so many jobs, feeling bad for the times that she can't come see me play or run because she had to work just so I could eat. And I would always tell my mom, don't worry about it. It never really bothered me that you didn't come, because I knew what you were doing. And it was just always icing on the cake when you was there. I want to thank my brother for always being an inspiration. Growing up, I wanted to do everything that he did. That's why, you know, I love Southwest DeKalb so much. And I had to be the bros, it just wasn't even an option. My sister, who came into my life and just showed me what an angel she is by always being in fervent prayer, always being up-spirited, and always having kind words. No matter what she's going through, she always finds a way. I appreciate and I love all of them for that. I have to talk about my grandparents, because they were so influential in my upbringing. My grandfather, may he rest in peace. I learned how to pick watermelon, raise cattle, and a lot of people say I act just like him because he really didn't talk much at all, and I guess I only talk when I feel I need to. And my grandmother, who's 92 years old, who's always been so strong, and she's always been the glue to our family. My grandmother taught me the 23rd Psalm. My grandmother taught me the Lord's Prayer. I was a kid, I didn't know any better. I was saying my grace while I went to bed. So, she heard that one night. And she took the time to teach me the Lord's Prayer. I want to thank my wife, because I know that it's been challenging and difficult putting up with me at times. But I told you that when you met me, I was going to always been very supportive. I mean, just this in itself, you know. They always said, behind every good black man is the police. But my wife, babe, I love you.
I appreciate you.
And it's been so wonderful being with you through the frustrating times, through the ups and the downs. And, you know, I love you very much. I want to thank Coach Cobb, Coach Napoleon Cobb, my high school coach, who saw in me almost 20 years ago that I would be a great hurdler. And it's so amazing because I just got finished. We had a track meet when I was on junior varsity. I was in the ninth grade. We had a track meet and I watched the hurdlers. And I said to myself, there is no way in the world I would ever run hurdles. I see boys falling all over the place and hurdles flying all over the place. I didn't want any parts of that. And Coach Cobb came to me on that Monday and said, Trammell, walk with your son. I want you to be my hurdler. And I looked at him and I said, no, you don't. He said, you got the build for it. You got pretty good foot speed. And he said, I feel like I'm gonna make you a champion. And lo and behold, we worked every day for a month straight. I was always the last one off the track, always the last one in the weight room. It would be Coach Carr right there with me every step of the way. When I won my first state title, when I broke the national high school record, when I made my first Olympic team, when I got my first Olympic medal, he was my primary coach when I got my second Olympic medal. I can go to him right now today
He's still at Southwest Decatur. We can sit up and talk about anything. He's always treated me as if I were his son. And I appreciate him for that because I see him as my other dad. I want to thank everybody that's come out, all my fraternity brothers, all my brothers who grew up with me on each level. We had a real good run. We had a real good run. Three guys from the same city come up together through the ranks. And every last one, a world champion or Olympic champion in his own right. It's nothing but a blessing. And I appreciate you guys, and I love you guys, and I know that we will set more examples in this next chapter of our lives. I want to thank Coach Page for showing me what real effort is in coaching, to truly care about someone's being outside of just their athletic prowess. Coach Page, I appreciate you a whole lot more than you know. And when you came to me in July and said, Terrence, after I had a couple of not so good years, he said, Terrence, this is what I see. I think you can come along for one more indoor season, just indoors, and break this world record in the 60 meter hurdles, and then I see you when I see you. And I said, well, Coach, right now you're the only one that see that. But then just today, I called him. I said, Coach, I'm still praying on it. Still reading my scriptures. My wife gave me permission. And I said, if I come back, I want to hit this one with everything I got. Not only do I want the world record in hurdles, but I want the world record in 60. And then I see you when I see you. You guys, my heart, I don't know what to say, but I spoke here for the last, I don't know how long. But I'm overjoyed, really I am. This was a beautiful thing. It would take the mind of my wife to be able to pull this off. Again, you all, I really appreciate it. Coming in from out of state, catching airplanes to get here. My family who came from South Carolina that had to go back to tend to their sick baby. It just really means a lot. It really means a lot. I guess that means I'm a pretty big deal around here. Thank you all. May God cover you all. May He bless you all abundantly for the love that you all have shown me. May He continue to protect you all in the shadow of His wings. May He continue to show His face upon you all. I thank you all so much. Thank you all so much.
Okay, so real quick, originally, remember, it was a retirement party. Then I had to quick resend everything out because I overheard the conversation between me and the Coach Page. I